Tenpin Bowling Show is proudly brought to you by your local ABPA and Goldpin Tenpin Bowling Centres.
Hi and welcome back to Narre Warren Super Bowl. I'm Jeanette Baker and we're here now at the final, we hope, the grand final of the ladies division of the 2010 Schweppes Melbourne Cup. Brenton Davey to tell us all about the players. Brenton.
Thank you, Jeanette. This is the Repercharge final. Last week, Bianca Flanagan with a magnificent 247 game defeated Esther Cheah from Malaysia with 206. However, a late ball change on Esther's troublesome right lane. She seems to have found the line. I expect this one to be very, very close. This is the final, the 2010 Women's Schweppes Melbourne Cup. Up to Michael in commentary.
Thank you, Brenton, and welcome to this week's edition of the Tenpin Bowling Show. We're covering the ladies' grand final repercharge match of the 2010 Schweppes Melbourne Tenpin Cup. Featuring Bianca Flanagan of Queensland, who has made it all this way. She's faced off against Esther Cheah of Malaysia. But she's now got herself into one mighty battle, getting through the first match, 247-206. Welcome, Brenton Davey.
Thanks, Michael. And there's the one thing that occasionally causes Bianca a little bit of trouble. She gets it down a little bit early. Ball has a tendency to dive through the nose, but she keeps breaking those splits up.
And I suppose as long as she keeps doing that, she's always in with a shot. She's an exceptional spare shooter.
Hasn't looked like missing anything so far. Her spare shooting's been just, yeah, absolutely ideal. Throws it hard and straight at everything.
And now to our number one seed, Esther Cheah from Malaysia. She went down to Bianca Flanagan last week, but being top seed, she did have the right to repercharge. And why wouldn't you? She has got a great opportunity to capture one of Australia's major 10-pin tournaments.
She's finished very well on this lane last week, and she's still there.
Oh, look out. Esther Cheah throws the first ball down, carries all 10 with a very confident pocket hit. And this is going to be one mighty battle.
The ball that she was using for most of last week was pinned down and a brand of ball that tends to roll a bit earlier. The ball she's using now is one that pin up tends to go longer anyway. And there's the result.
Wow, what a start from Esther Cheah. Didn't even look like finding the pocket last week, but these first two shots have been exceptional.
And I tell you what, you do not make a Malaysian squad without being able to bowl. I mean, it's almost their national sport over there.
Now, every bowler that comes out of that country is quite exceptional. She's showing her class right now. But she's up to the task. Throws a strike of her own.
For the non-bowler, it's difficult to appreciate just how good, just how outstanding this level of bowling is. You know, this lane condition is super tough. Players are having to play way outside of their comfort zone.
Oh.
And the occasional good break doesn't hurt.
Well, we can't say if Bianca hasn't had her fair share of them. Going right through the nose and breaking up the split. That's twice she's been inside. On the left-hand lane, we'll be interested to see what happens when she gets back up there.
Oh!
And when your opponent gets a good break, the more on a shot tends to not get a good result. Shakes her head as she walks back there. She knew it was okay, but surely did not deserve the 4-9 split.
Not a leave you normally see off a deep inside line either. Had to have a go at it.
Takes one. And now finds herself behind, and with all the work to do.
desperately unlucky with that shot.
Up at the top of the fourth. And another great shot from Esther. She hasn't let the last frame trouble her too much. She's right back up on the horse.
It's just indicative of how disciplined the Malaysian players are. You know, they're just very mentally strong.
She's been right on the left-hand lane for the good part of 9 or 10 frames, I think, but Bianca keeps pushing her luck.
Yeah, that was Bianca's sister, Jade, sitting up there in the back row of the grandstand. Also a former national team player and extremely handy bowler in her own right.
But unlike Esther, Bianca trips out the four pin and only has a single pin to attend to.
And again, I think that just comes down to just having a slightly better matchup with ball speed, rotation and revolutions.
And the home crowd there giving Bianca a clap. She stayed clean so far through four. Breaks the wrist, goes hard and straight. And I don't think she's missed one so far through the telecast of the Melbourne Tenpin Cup. She's been very, very good.
Spare shooting has been outstanding. But she knows she has a battle on her hands in this match. Got that one out a little bit better, but whoa. Interesting. She got that one well over the line, but it definitely looked like it broke a little early.
I'm just not too sure whether the ball fell out of the hand just that tiny bit sooner.
I wouldn't have thought so, because she got the ball well out over the foul line.
Anyway, breaks up another split and leaves herself a six pin. And another spare goes on the scorecard for Bianca. Bowling well, but you'd feel nine spares aren't going to cut it.
I would agree with you there, and just at the moment, the last couple of frames was just a little bit like Esther all of a sudden is just throwing it a hair more confidently.
There's maybe a tiny bit of pressure being felt by Bianca maybe at this point. We'll see what Esther can do. Bottom of the fifth.
Ooh.
Another positive shot in her support base. Not appreciating that 10 pin too much. It's not far away.
Not far away at all. Just that break point, it just looked like it was just that hair late. Might have been just a hair up on the ball speed, possibly. But it was a good quality shot nonetheless.
Needed the flush 10, and the double would have brought her on level pegging. Goes back and contends with the spare pin. Well done to Esther. She's within 12 pins as we take a break. And welcome back to the Tenpin Bowling Show's coverage of the 2010 Schweppes Melbourne Tenpin Cup. You're witnessing the ladies' grand final repercharge match between Bianca Flanagan of Queensland and Esther Cheah of Malaysia. Esther up on the sixth frame.
Oh dear. Oh no. Really hasn't had anything good happen in this match. Hasn't had the breaks. Bianca's been breaking up those hits. And unfortunately, Esther, a little bit softer ball speed. Had to have a go at it, I think. Looking at that, she had no choice but to have a go at that.
Yeah, considering she was 12 pins down going into that frame, she really needed to convert there.
Had a go at it. Just threw it just a hair too wide, and Bianca now in with a massive opportunity.
Huge opportunity here to bury Esther. She's thrown that one inside herself. Breaks up another split. She's all smiles at the moment, and why wouldn't she be?
And you wonder, yeah, when one bowler's breaking the splits up and one isn't, you think, is it a matter of luck? Well, to a degree it is, but Bianca's role, and I've said it before and I'll say it till I'm blue in the face, the role pattern and the matchup of the speed and the revs and the layout of the ball to the lane condition is just, I think, that little bit better than Esther's. Just matches up that little bit better with this particular pair.
You've been blue in the face for some time, Brenton. but of course no less correct. Bianca Flanagan up now on the seventh frame and has a good opportunity to put a good space between her and her opponent. Another pocket hit, another 10 down. Things starting to look ominous.
Six pin really did the job on the 10 pin that time. Kicked it out. Bianca now with a 25 pin lead, but it is by no means insurmountable.
Well, 25 pins with 2.5 frames to go, you'd feel pretty comfortable. You'd just about have your first name on that trophy.
Almost, but not just yet.
Esther gets up on the seventh. Kicks out that nine pin. I'll tell you what, had she left that, I'm not too sure what she could have done.
Have a look again. Solid the line. She's throwing the ball aggressively. She cannot be faulted with the aggression she's using with the shot. Just needs to get a break or two.
Especially in this left lane. Oh. And just not catching it. Finding another flush pocket hit. Leaving the four. Generally happens when it's a high shot.
Yeah. Last week it was the right-hand lane causing a problem. This week it looks like it's the left-hand lane.
Malaysian support crowd are just scratching their heads at the moment, discussing what could possibly be going wrong for Esther. She just needs a break or two. That's all she needs.
She's so close. She is so close to being able to put a string together.
Keeps herself within the match, though. She's sparing whatever she can.
Esther has made all her makeable spares. Both these ladies have been spare shooting immaculately.
In fact, the only one she hasn't been able to spare out have been the splits.
That's right, and have a look at that one. That was identical to Bianca's last shot. Snap that 10 pin out of there. Six pin, have a look at the six pin. Second from your right.
Laid up against the wall and got all the action it needed.
Butt of the six pin came off the wall. Kneecap the 10. This will almost lock it up.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
There is yet another twist to this awesome ladies' final. Throws a confident shot, hits the pocket, leaves the dreaded 8-10.
All I can say there is, I think there was a bit, might have been some adrenaline there, because I think the ball speed was just too high. Break point was far too late down the lane, and the ball just never got into a heavy roll. Leaves the 8-10 split, which is generally indicative of a poor release, but I think that was a bit of ball speed and a bit of adrenaline. That's really closed it up.
Does that open the door for Esther Cheah? That's what remains to be seen.
This is a good lane. She's been hitting this lane. She throws a strike here, and if she can find a way in on the left-hand lane, anything could happen.
Just saw her say a couple of things to herself, and I think she's mentally done the sums in her head. She knows what's required. Oh, yes! Gets the carry, Esther. Finally, a good break for her. Puts a strike on that card. But I think the job really needs to be done. She needs to close out.
She closes out. She can shoot 202. Bianca Flanagan would then be required
to make any kind of mark.
To make a mark and decent count. Strike spare would be 203.
Great shot. Some emotion coming out of Esther there, I believe. Just finally getting a couple of the good breaks that have been wayward from her earlier in the match. But finding the pocket hit a little bit lighter. And that is a great, great shot there.
She's just been more and more aggressive through the bottom of the swing. She's been accelerating through the release point. The follow-through's whipped past her right here. And she's just found another gear.
I'll tell you what, this shot is ultra important right now. Strike here, and Bianca has to show up.
Oh, got the break now.
What a carry.
Getting a break on the carry now. Is it too late?
Split the 4-7 up. That's fantastic. And just good count here. And Bianca will be forced to close the 10th frame at least.
To tell you what, a strike is important. Oh, it's inside.
It's an 8 count. And she closes out her game with a respectable 200. And this requires Bianca to throw at least a mark plus 8 pins.
A strike there was really important for Esther. That would have meant Bianca would have needed to fill a full 20 pins. She would have needed a spare and a strike in the 10th. Now she can get it with a spare and 8.
Yes, whether the strike spare came or whether the spare strike came, it really didn't matter.
Oh, gee whiz, that was...
That's a very nervous shot. And all of a sudden, she hasn't missed a spare yet. But this one, to keep herself in the title race. It's a modest four pin. Modest four pin. But this, to stay in the match.
See what she does here. Never in doubt, great spare. But it's not all over yet. She needs an 8 count and to win the Melbourne Cup.
8 with this ball. We'll see her name engraved with some of the country's greats. Time to compose. Slip the fingers into the ball. Line up the feet. Emotions and adrenaline in check. But we'll see what happens.
This for the win. That's a bit wide.
Oh, it's a 7
count.
The match is tied, ladies and gentlemen, and we will go to a 9th and 10th frame roll-off. And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the conclusion of the 2010 Schweppes Melbourne Tenpin Cup. This is the ladies' grand final. If one game wasn't enough, we've had two. And then we've had a tie at the end of the second game. And we are now forced into a 9th and 10th frame roll-off. Esther Cheah from Malaysia will start proceedings. If you haven't been through this before, folks, Brent and Davey, please take us through it.
Well, basically, we re-bowl the 9th and 10th frames, starting from scratch. Oh, broke high. Oh, didn't think it was that bad a shot. It was a high hit, no doubt. It wasn't flush through the beak. That was very, very unlucky. And in a two-frame roll-off, you don't want to go getting bad breaks like that.
Esther's grand final campaign has much been a run of bad luck. But she'll go back. She really needs to take one in this situation. Maximise her count, because in two frames you never know what can happen.
Now Bianca will get up and bowl her 9th and 10th frames. The best Esther can shoot is 39.
That is assuming she puts 3 strikes together in the 10th.
Maximum for a 9th and 10th frame roll-off score is 60. That's high.
Not coming across, but she takes 8 with her first ball. Home crowd willing her on. But this spare is much more attainable. What would normally be a simple 6-10 under this kind of pressure.
The spare shooting's just been sensational, hasn't it, Michael? Unbelievable spare shooting under unbelievable pressure.
She's been brilliant. Throughout the telecast, she has not missed a single spare. And that, folks, is truly one of a kind.
Well, it was my mistake. I thought that Bianca was going to throw the 9th and 10th, but...
Esther now to try and put some pressure on.
There it is. Wow.
That's
like
a good
that
shot.
Love that shot. That's just... That's that all class right there.
And funny enough, it was only a board maybe outside of what she needed on the left-hand lane.
Two more strikes and she makes Bianca throw really good count. Oh no, it's a bit wide. Ooh, nearly got the break.
And that really is a shame. With a spare here, she will finish her two-frame roll-off with 29. And all Bianca would need to do is throw a mark.
Any kind of spare or strike, and Bianca Flanagan will be your 2010 Schweppes Melbourne Cup champion.
But I tell you what, Esther walks out in style. She's had a fantastic campaign, been in the top two or three for the whole tournament, and to go down at the last hurdle in such circumstances.
This is a shot for the tournament, right here.
It's flush. It's home. The 2010 Schweppes Melbourne 10-pin cup trophy goes to an Australian. The home crowd appreciative. Standing ovation.
And just that deeper angle has just worked in her favour so well in this match. Just to prove it wasn't a fluke, she does it again.
She's really owned the pocket, hasn't she? In the telecast she's been on these last couple of weeks, she's really turned it on. She's been very strong through the swing. She has not given up an ounce of commitment to any of her shots. And that right there, folks, is a result of 100% commitment. But the last shot still to come. It's party time right now. Does she finish it off with another one? You betcha. She finishes off. And it's on the two-frame roll-off, 50-29. But what circumstances? Bianca Flanagan is your 2010 Ladies Champion of the 2010 Melbourne Tenpin Cup.
And it's time for the presentations for the 2010 Schweppes Women's Melbourne Tenpin Cup. Here at the presentation stage with me is Brenton Stanton from Schweppes, Lorraine Sampson, the owner and managing director of the OzTenpin Entertainment Centres, and our three finalists. And we'd like to present firstly our third place winner from the Northern Territory, Rebecca Voukolos.
Thank you for that.
We'd like to say a few words, please, Rebecca.
Yeah, it was an absolute awesome weekend, definitely. I'd like to congratulate Bianca as well. You know, that was a great win. She bowled well all weekend, and she definitely deserved to win. So, yeah, that's about it.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Rebecca Voukolos. And our second place getter from Malaysia, Esther Cheah.
I'd just like to congratulate Bianca as well. She bowled really well. It was a really close match and it was entertaining, definitely more entertaining than the guys. So that's a good thing for once. So yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much, Esther. And our champion for the 2010 Schweppes Women's Melbourne Cup from Queensland, Bianca Flanagan. Would you like to say a few words, please?
Sure. Firstly, I'd like to thank Narre Warren Bowl and OzTenpin for everything they did this weekend. It was a wonderful weekend and very successful, and looking forward to coming back next year. Thank you very much to Schweppes and all of the prize money and everything they did for us this weekend. It's been really good, and it's good to see that they've come back on board for another 3 years. I'd like to thank my family and my coach, James McGinty, for everything he's done with me. And lastly, I'd like to thank Team Storm Australia for supplying me with the best bowling balls in the world.
Nice plug there, Bianca. And Brenton Stanton will present you with the winner's check.
Thank you very much.
And ladies and gentlemen, that's it. From OzTenpin, Narre Warren, on behalf of the OzTenpin Group, and the Tenpin Bowling Show, we'll see you next week.
The Tenpin Bowling Show was proudly brought to you by your local ABPA and Goldpin Tenpin Bowling Centres.